So normally I don't make videos about USB Type-C cables because pretty much all USB Type-C cables that I've tested for myself but also used for myself for charging phones, a lot of Bluetooth speakers. But somehow this brand just wanted to send it out and I was like, okay, let's do it. So this cable is a bit different than other USB Type-C cables. So it is magnetic. So this means, as you can see, if you like roll it over, it stays in one piece. So it is pretty easy to do this. So for example, you now have it like in one piece and then you can like turn it all around and you can like see, fold it up and up. So yes, it's cool. But this magnetic stuff, it is cool for at home, but magnetic stuff, especially with phones, is not always a great combination. So some phones have problems with GPS stuff. But yeah, it's cool that something like this exists, especially for at home. You can organize your cables a bit more and to let you guys see if this cable is even working. Because yeah, let's be honest, there are a lot of cables that you can buy and they don't work. So let's put this into this phone. Even though this phone has a full battery, it does say it's now charging. So that's pretty cool. The funny thing with this cable, as with the magnetic stuff, is also it's thick cable. And something I did notice with this cable is that it's heavy. Like if you have your phone on this cable, you don't really feel that too much, but especially if you have this cable like just so in your hand, it definitely has some heft to it. And a funny thing with this magnetic stuff, you can also do it like this a bit magnetic, so here you go, and then it's still not as beautiful, but it's still pretty organized. So is this magnetic stuff a gimmick or is it really usable? I would say for at home it's definitely usable. It's more organized way of keeping your cables together, but also like have them a bit more like cooler together. I do still think if you use them in a car, I did experience this with this cable with my own phone, the Vivo, you do have some interference with this cable with the GPS of the phone. So do be aware, this kind of cables, it's really well, very well done for at home. But if you really want to use it in your car, you can better use a normal USB cable. But let's be honest, if you use a USB cable in your car, this cable will also stay pretty much almost in your car. Not a lot of people will like remove the cable out of the car and then going to use it somewhere else. So it's a pretty cool cable. And yeah, it's also a long one, this one, like 1.5 meter. So it's also usable in length. And again, it is a heavy cable. You definitely feel it has those magnetic stuff inside. So yeah, pretty cool. So in this video, it was meant to talk about this cable, but I also like to talk about the phone which I have here. So this Motorola, it is a budget phone, but this phone has surprised me on a few sides of this like budget stuff. And a funny thing with this phone especially is that it has a lot of memory. So it has like 256 gigabytes of memory. So that means that it's really like usable for your media. The funny thing also here on the side, this phone has like this very fast power button fingerprint scanner. So it's really like you put the finger on it and there it is. It's really impressive for a budget phone that you have this kind of fingerprint solution. So yeah, where do you see where this is a budget phone? You can see it on the screen side. So this is like just a normal IPS screen. So at least it's IPS, but it is no AMOLED. It's also not like the sharper screen. So it's only like, I believe, 1080p. And on the rear, it's all plastic on the sides as well. The cameras, the main camera is usable. And really, if I take a photo, for example, from the camera that's now recording, it also has some rendering or it's also like adjusting the picture. Something I did notice with this phone is that the autofocus doesn't always work that correctly. So it's a bit of a downside about this phone. So especially if you have some light behind the subject, you do have this like flare stuff and everything, but it's still a usable photo. And especially if you zoom in, you do still see some things on this phone, for example, that's recording. So for a budget phone, this phone is really cool and it does get updates. It's really speedy even. So the chip they used inside this phone is very efficient. So the battery goes like 2 days or so. But it still is pretty speedy. And with this 120 Hz screen, even though it's only like an IPS display with not a lot of great colors. It is 120 Hz, so it does feel very smooth, and especially with this like finish on the back, it feels very rugged actually. So this is really definitely a phone that not necessarily I would use for daily use, but it's definitely a great thing to have as a backup phone, because it has a lot of memory. It is speedy enough to be used with the apps I use, for example also YouTube, but also some graphic stuff. And the camera, even though it's not great, it is usable if needed. So yeah, for like, I believe I paid around 150 euros or so for this phone. It's a pretty cool phone. And yeah, so cool cable, cool budget phone. So this is the video. Normally this video would only be about the cable, but then it would be a pretty short video. So I was like, you know what, let's also talk about my secondary phone, because this phone will be used a lot for my music stuff at the moment. So pretty cool. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and see you guys in the next one.